All right. I believe this is day 4 of the airbrushing lionfish project. Let's get started on this. We're going to be working some of this area today. Again, same thing. Using handheld mask. We're using the Createx 4012 high performance reducer. The Createx Grisaille Grays. This is neutral number 4. I don't know if you can see it or not. To get started, I've mixed up. Again, we're using HP-HB, BH, I'm sorry, with my Micron mods added to it. Flare soft string, short trigger on it. We're mixing the paint. I believe it's 8 drops of the 4012 to about 10 drops of the neutral number 4 illustration gray. So let's get started here. Dust in some paint here, that color. Like I was saying before, just need a slight dusting, give us some markings there. We're not trying to get everything exact right now. We're just marking some areas of what we're going to work with and where we're going to work. Whether it's with the Grisailles or any of the illustration paints, really, you know, you can work whatever way you prefer. I just like to, use some handheld shields. Kind of gives them an easy way to get a nice hard line in. You can pretty much match. Natural curves with it. Not be too concerned about having to fix things. Or freehanding. You know, I try to leave the freehanding for the detail stuff. Try to also incorporate the shield because of the fact that you won't have to go back and erase areas and things of that nature. And you can get some pretty good looking effects out of it. I never did it too much. So that's kind of what I like, the way I like to work. You see, you got a little fuzzy area there, so we just go back in and clean up that line.
Sing together one more time.
cleaned up that edge again. Like before, using the Faber-Castell Perfection 10 58 eraser. It's a kind of a medium hard eraser. When the paint is fresh like this, you get a real nice smooth hard line down. And even like this paint here that was laid down a couple of days ago, I can still go back and get a nice hard edge down. Jack Johnson and friends, Donovan Frankenrider. Just some different music for you guys. Kind of chill, mellow Sunday afternoon for me. Dusting from the stencil out towards the surface so that I can control the edge in the paint a little bit better. That way you don't have to really get down in there to look for get that nice hard edge. A little bit of movement on my part. The backside of the stencil, that's one thing you gotta worry about with the stencils. Making sure that where you spray the stencil on either side, it's that paint has dried. Apparently, it wasn't dry. So I normally keep a towel, paper towel, or something. Wipe the edges that I'm working on. So you can go back as if these are. Stencils are solvent proof. You go back in and spray some cleaner on there or some reducer. If you're in a hurry, just take a paper towel and throw some reducer on there and wipe that edge. Blow it dry with your airbrush and move on pretty quickly. It's something that's really getting some thickness to it where it's causing your edge to be a little distorted or fuzzy, and you still need that hard edge, then every once in a while I got through and I'll just clean them all with the solvent cleaners. And acetone alcohol works real well. Sometimes you can even use some of the green type cleaners. I like to use that simple green. That's a simple green spray bottle. And just spray it on there. Let it set for a little while in paper towel and scrub off the acrylic paint. I don't use solvent based paints, water based paints, cleaners, Windex, alcohol, rubbing alcohol, something that's 70% or higher. The lower percentage of alcohol really don't do a whole lot. Reducer, Createx Airbrush Cleaner works good, and really got something tough, some automotive acetone loop on it too, without the mylar, whatever this plastic surface is. So it really helps. But then the real key to any of the cleaning is making sure it is completely dry when you're done. So because with that on that surface, any little bit is going to reactivate your paints, which you don't want to do. Go back up here and keep going. Add some more of this darker color in here.
What you do it just in your own way. Take my day into night. Still give me all that love and light. Love and light. Yeah. Even though I can't see it all the time.
bit harder eraser, get rid of that residue and get it back to the That's the, see if we can get this, the hard eraser. These are real hard to find these days, but it's an Eberhard Faber, which you know, are from the Faber company, but this is an American version instead of the Faber-Castell. And it's a single FX. It's really a typewriter eraser. Very rare to find these days. It's number 10. It's got really aggressive eraser on it, but it doesn't take a whole lot to peel the paint off, erase the surface for you. You can sharpen it at angles and things like that, get some real fine lines for creating hair textures and fur and things like that. But when you need a good hard edge and get down to the surface without damaging the surface, you know, then that's what I choose to use. Makes it a little bit quicker. I don't like to use, you know, the X-Acto too much for scraping any other metal type scraping, because you got to be real careful on this Blair surface that you don't gouge that initial surface here. Because once you get below this initial surface, it's not the same, texture, type of surface that it is below that substrate, since it's a plastic type substrate. It's a PVC type material. It tends to have some different properties when you get down into that next layer and stuff. And plus, you'll see an edge show up, and it could cause some peeling of this top surface. So you gotta be real careful with erasing and scratching on pretty much any surface. This is pretty durable for erasers and stuff like that, provided you don't cut into that layer. If you cut into that layer and it creates that edge, it'll start peeling up eventually. And once it peels up, that's where the paint's sticking. It peels the paint along with it, because the paint bonds really well with it. So just a word of caution for you there. Back into a dream on the ground, looking up at the sun coming down. Into a world where boys and girls are holding handheld devices while they're eating and sleeping. A little darker color in there. That the prices will be paid down the line. When the ice melts, maybe it will turn to wine. And all the greatest of the heroes started jumping from the books. They started wearing ones and zeros, looking more and more like crooks. They stole the sunlight from the future, took a sip, they had the glass and put it back. And a lot of people like to have a feast, not so many can stomach the pill. A lot of traffic on the streets, so who's really doing all the drilling? Keep on filling, what can never be full. My imagination got a hold. There's this fire trying to climb through the window into my life. I don't mind. There's this wine trying to find its way from the bottle to my mind. In my mind. It's a magic number. Yes, it is. It's a magic number. Because 2 times 3 is 3 times 6 is. And guys, get this edge in here. We got 3 R's we're going to talk about today. We got to learn to reduce, reuse, recycle. Reduce, reuse, recycle. Reduce, reuse, recycle. Well, if you're going to the market to buy some juice, you gotta bring your own bags and you learn to reduce your waste. We gotta learn to reduce. And if your brother or your sister's got some cool clothes, you can try them on before you buy some more of those we use. We gotta learn to reduce. Some of those stripes. And if the first 2 arms don't work out, and if you gotta make some trash, well, don't throw it out. Recycle. Fill that edge. We gotta learn to recycle. Magic number. kind of playing connect the dots now to bring that all together as one shape. As you can see, I was connecting different parts of it to kind of create that. I'll follow the line with a hard line. Then we'll come back in. Like I said, clean up. Eraser.
Everyone knows what went down because the news was spread all over town. A fact is only what you believe. A fact and fiction work as a team. It's almost always fiction. A magazine, suggestions on where to place faith, suggestions on what to believe, but I read somewhere that you've got to beware, you can't believe anything you read, but the good book is good and that's well understood, so don't even question if you know what I mean, but it's all relative. Even if you don't understand, well, it's all in the story. Especially when you don't understand, well, it's all just because. Even if we don't understand, well, it's all just for me. There you go. Once again, you missed the point, and then you point your fingers at me. I say that I said not to believe.
Two little figure eights in here. That'll also create a texture. These darker areas and stuff. It doesn't all look
about what just happened. You know we've been through it all. I thought the love we built would never fall. I thought I'd never fall.
is a trendy, mommy is too. Again, doing the same kind of thing as before. You know, I got some paint in there, so whenever I utilize the paint, I'll attend there to make you an offer you can't refuse. I'll make you an offer that you won't lose. You won't lose it, baby. Every time you walk out that door, I just love you more. Baby, won't you stay here with me? Can we get those white areas back in there? Every time you walk out that door, I just love you more. Tracing in little tiny circular motions. You can try to retain some of that light base color that's in there. Still giving an organic feel. Trying to keep these areas as white as possible and as close to the original shape. And I'll go back in. We'll get to work on those areas. And if it needs a harder edge in there, then
together.
look at all those fancy clothes. But these could keep us warm just like those. What about your soul? Is it cold? Is it straight from the mold and ready to be sold? Cars and phones and diamond rings, bling bling, those are only removable things. And what about your mind? Does it shine on? Are there things that concern you more than your time? Gone, going, gone, everything gone, give a damn. Gone be the birds when they don't wanna sing. Gone people, all awkward with their things. Gone. Look at you out to make a deal. You try to be appealing, but you lose your appeal. And what about those shoes you're in today? They'll be no good on the bridges you burnt along the way. Oh, you willing to sell anything? Gone with your hurt. Leave your footprints, will shrink with our world.
Alrighty. Yeah, that's pretty much what I'm going to work on for today. Call it here, and I'm going to run out of paint, so we're going to end it. So, end of day 4. Have a great one.